Hello, students. Today we will discuss the last two elements of design, color and value. So let us look at color and discuss a little bit about what it is and what is its importance as an element of design. Now, color plays a big role in any design. I mean, any of you will agree that color is a very emotional element. Imagine you design something and you do not put any color. You leave it as black and white, for example. Or you add a color to it, or more than one color. It changes the whole emotional aspect of your design just by adding a certain color or colors or color combination. So if you look at these, for example, illustrations, imagine, remove the color and imagine them in, for example, black and white. It will give a totally different emotional aspect to the viewer. So color is a very, very powerful element of design. It can be used in a very powerful way to convey your message in your design. Now, if used wrongly, it can also destroy your design and the message you want to convey using the wrong colors, the wrong color combinations. All can have a bad effect. Here we have some more examples. Look at this interior, for example. By adding certain colors in certain places, it gives a very specific emotional aspect to this interior. Imagine if you used other colors or in a different way, or if you didn't use colors, it will be a totally different interior. Like if I change all the colors now, with others, the whole interior will change in the eyes of the observer. In advertising or in products, the same thing. Look at this color combination, what effect it gives us. So if you look around you, just look at the colors. Look at the colors. Imagine if you replace the colors you see with other colors. What will be the effect, the emotional effect? Color, using color, can give emphasis in certain parts of your design. Like you can, for example, have any kind of design and you want a certain area to stand out. Like when I look at your design to see that certain area like standing out from your, for example, drawing or a real object, if you have, or an interior. It doesn't matter what kind of design. So you can create some emphasis. We will talk about emphasis more later, but you can emphasize certain areas as being more important than others using color. You can use it to organize your design. So color you can use to make your design look organized or organize it in a certain way. I don't have any example for this right now, but for example, if you notice, if you have a TV at home and you have a remote control, everybody has this, just look at the way, for example, color is used in the buttons of the remote control. Sometimes the color is organizing them into groups. For example, these groups have certain colors, the other groups, other colors, for example, black, others are white. Then you see, for example, a few are with red or red and other colors. So it gives you a visual organization to the design. Now, if you use color in a wrong way, it can also create chaos in your design. So it's a very critical element and it needs a lot of observation, a lot of basically knowledge in this to apply it in a correct way. The problem is every design is different. So the use of the color is also different. As we said, whatever we study here, it is guidelines for you, not rules. You have to adapt. You have to adapt what you learn and what you hear according to your design and what you need to communicate in your design. Color can evoke certain emotions. We already talked about emotion, emotional connection with the element color. It's very big. Color can also be used to grab attention or stimulate interest in a certain area. Imagine you have a design, an illustration, and everything is black and white, and then you have only this area colored. It will draw my attention to this area. It will stimulate interest. Like why the designer made this area, for example, colorful, and the other area no. Every color tells us something different. You know, we have so many colors and color combinations. Now we have primary colors, but when we combine them, we create more and more variations. And we will see in a bit some example of this. So it tells us, every color tells us something different. So when you look, for example, at red, it gives you a totally different emotional response than if you look at blue or green, for example. Now, maybe you will not be able to tell straight away, express it verbally. What does it make you feel? But there is plenty of information out there that would actually help you with verbalizing these feelings. We will see also some example in a minute of the meaning of the different colors and in general what they can mean when looking at them. Now, color in general is the color you see, the color you see with your eyes is when the light, is when light strikes an object and is reflected back to your eye. So you see this color that is reflected back. Now, what about white and black? What about white and black? How is that? How do those work? So in white, when the light hits an object, all of it is reflected back. All of it is reflected back to your eye. This is why you see white. But when you have black, then all the light is absorbed. There is no reflection to your eye. So you see black. So black means the absence of color, basically. And white has all the colors in it, white light. Now, here we have a few of the general meanings, I would say, of color. Like, for example, when we see something in red, okay? We already talked about how colors could affect us in a way, like emotionally, I would say. Okay, so when we see red, something triggers in our mind that there could be, for example, danger. That's why you will see stop signs colored in red. Certain buttons of certain devices are in red for certain reasons, again. So stop buttons in devices are also often colored in red. So this is like, it gives us a universal feeling of something could be dangerous here, okay? Also, it has excitement, passion, and energy, you know, the red color. All of these things, these feelings, it can make us feel when we see red. Now, it depends where we see this red, in what context we see red. So sometimes we can feel red is energetic. At other times, we can feel it's a danger. It depends on the context on what is happening around this color. Because you don't have color alone. Usually you have, usually in a design, you have color with shape, with other things going on. So what is the object actually? You can have a three-dimensional object, a two-dimensional illustration or drawing. It really depends on what is around, what is behind, what is the context in which this color was used. This influences the meaning and the feeling that you get when seeing it. The same with the other colors. Each color has certain feelings attached to it, certain meaning, certain response that we feel when we look at this color. Now, you need to be careful, okay? Even though this, and you will find a lot more information if you search online about psychological meanings of color, general meanings of color, everything. You'll find a lot more information than this. But pay attention that, for example, different cultures have different connotations for color. Like connotations, like the meaning, the feeling that you get. What does it make you think or feel or see? So in some cultures, for example, when you take white and black, like in most cultures, the white is kind of the positive, the pure color. The black is considered like with attached with sadness sometimes. It can also, it depends on the context again. It can mean also luxury, or it can mean death, okay? But in some cultures, all of this can be opposite. Like for example, in some cultures, the black is associated with the pureness and the white is with death, okay? So not all cultures see and feel the same things looking at color, but usually there are universal aspects that are used. So these are kind of exceptions, but they exist. They exist and they can cause confusion. So when you design something and you think, okay, the person looking at it will feel in this way, but then a person from another culture looks at your design and feels a totally different thing. So you need to be to understand this aspect of the human psychology. The color circle, okay? Now you will study more about it, and actually you will study much more about color and even the physics with behind color. How does color work and function? Everything, you will study it in another class. The intention here is not to cover color in its full range, because this will need a whole semester basically. So you will have another class where you will cover in detail the knowledge of color theory. It's called, the class is called color theory, and you will take it in this university at some point. You will study it for a whole semester. This, what we explain about color is more about the application of color. So the meanings, the psychology, the feelings that we get, it's not the science behind color, just know about it. So I will not discuss the color wheel here in great detail, but what we see in colors, okay, in general. So we can divide the color wheel into warm and cool colors, warm and cold. Again, what does warm colors make us feel and cool colors? And when we apply this in a design, the effect can be totally different. Like if I apply warm or cool colors. Warm colors from the name, warm. It sometimes it makes you feel heat, warmth, closeness, coziness, you know. For example, if used in interior design, it can make the rooms look larger if you use the warm colors and more cozy. It it's more, you'll feel more comfortable sitting in a room that uses warm colors rather than very cold colors. Now, of course, you can use combinations, okay? And it can be very, the result can be amazing. But I'm talking about in general, like if you overdo it, if you overdo, for example, with cold colors, or you can even overdo it with warm colors, okay? And it can, the result can be very bad. So it depends on the balance, really, on the balance. But in general, warm colors come with their attached feelings, and cold colors also. So, for example, cool colors have the ability to calm and shoot. So they can make you a little bit feel calm, because the warm colors give, makes you feel a little more energetic. So, and cold colors and warm colors, they all remind us of certain things. Like, for example, green, blue, remind us of water, of sky. And this alone reflects back to us to a certain feeling. The warm colors, for example, if you see red, it could remind us of fire. This is very different than a blue color. So all of these things must be also taken into consideration when involved, when you're involved in a design. Again, here, this is a continuation. So the psychological effect of color, which we are already discussing. So the warm colors also can make us feel, for example, feelings of anger or hate, hostility, you know, because they involve a lot of energy. The cold colors are more calming, the cooler colors. But when you use these ideas in a design, again, you need to find this balance depending on what you are designing and what how are you going to combine the colors and in what degree. Like, for example, if you overdo it with the cold colors, it can create feelings of sadness or indifference. So it's you need to basically learn from observation. So observe around you and analyze. What do I see? What does this make me feel? Or what does something else make me feel? And observe just the color, and then observe the context of the design, the form, the environment, everything, to learn of how color is used and if it's used correctly, not correctly, and analyze what does it make you feel. You need to always analyze yourself. Like if I look at something and it makes me feel in a certain way, I need to ask myself, why? Why do I feel like this? If I don't ask these questions, I will never be able to develop as a designer. And when I design something, I will not know how to design, because I never analyzed even my own feelings. I don't understand my own brain. So how can I make other people, how can I influence other people with my design? I mean, if I don't understand my head, how can I understand other people's heads? So you need to really analyze yourselves and ask many questions. Here we have a few major terminology in used in color, so that you don't get confused. So if you hear hues, what is a hue? What is tints, shades, tones? These are very much used in color, okay? And as I said, we will not go in great detail here in this course to discuss color, but we need to touch a few of the major things. Like, for example, when you hear hue, it means the pure color, the pure color, the pure, for example, yellow, with no mixture in it with anything else. It's a pure color, okay? A tint, when you hear tint, it means the pure color plus white. So like here, for example, this is a tint, this is a hue, a pure color. And then what happens when we add white to this pure color? So here I add a little bit of white, here more, until the color fades out and becomes white. So this is called tints, the primary color plus adding white to it. When we have shades, look at the shades, it means the color, the primary, the main color with black. So here we can see the shade, okay, that this is the primary, the hue. Then we start adding black more and more and more until we end up with a very dark version of this color. Until if we continue adding black, it will look totally black at some point. The tone means adding gray to a pure hue. So this is the pure hue again. And then we start adding gray. What is gray? How to create gray? When we mix white plus black together, it creates gray. Now, if we mix equal amounts, we will create the medium gray. If we put more white, it will be lighter gray. If we put more black, it will be darker gray. But here we consider the medium gray. So the original hue, the color, and adding a gray to it, adding more and more and more gray. So these words you should be familiar with, but you will study more about this later. And here also you have the three primary colors, red, blue, and yellow, and you have secondary, and then intermediary, and you have a lot of types of combinations, and they all have their names and so on. But this is the major words you need to be familiar with. So if you hear tones, it means color plus gray. Shades, the color, the original one plus black. Tints, color plus white. The hues are the pure colors. I want to just discuss, now there are a lot of color systems, okay? A lot of them, and I will not go into it, except these two, the RGB and CMYK, because you will see them a lot, and anytime you design something on the computer and you want to print, you will come in contact with this. So I just want to cover it very quickly. So the what is the red, green, blue color system, and the CMYK, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Now, the RGB colors, they are made out of light, and you see on the screen. So when you design something on the screen, on a computer, using whatever program, Photoshop, Illustrator, you see the colors on your screen, RGB, okay? With red, green, blue light. Now you see them in a certain way. But when you go and print, for example, your poster, your whatever, okay, you're designing, they are printed, converting these colors into CMYK, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. These are inks. This is light. These are inks. Okay, now, what happens when you transfer colors you see on the screen into colors you see on the paper using inks? Because the printing machines use inks, and they use these inks, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, to make any color, okay? What happens? What happens is that sometimes you see something on the screen, like you see and you say, oh, these are right, this is the correct colors, my design looks perfect, and then you go and print it and your colors look different. They don't look like on the screen, so you are disappointed. Well, inks look different than light, okay? So you need to always consider that when you print something that you see on the screen, the result will not be the same. It's not because the quality of the printer is bad, it's because of the inks. So with experience, with printing a lot, designing and printing, you will get the experience of how colors change. So you can, you will not be shocked, you know, like when you go and print something and the colors are not exactly what you expected. That's why it's useful always to do test prints. Like if I have to do a project, I test print it in color before I submit it and don't leave it for the last day. Because you don't have time sometimes to make changes, you know? So these are the two major color systems you will see immediately as soon as you start any design, you know, on the computer and when you go to print anything. Just for you so that you know about them a little bit from now. But you will see there is a lot more information regarding color systems, but this is not our topic in this class to go into detail. Now, we will cover value now. We will talk about a little bit about value. Now, this is related to color, you know, if you remember, look, where did we have this? So look here, what I wrote, color, value, okay? And in brackets, tone, value, which means tone. Now look where we talked about this. Tones, look here, tones, which means the primary color adding gray to it. Now, why are we talking about value as a separate element of design if it's kind of part of color? Now it has a big importance on its own value. So we need to discuss it as a separate element of design, okay? And use it like that because alone it has, it's a world on its own value, okay? So it's not enough just to discuss it as part of the element color and to leave it. It is actually a separate element of design value on its own, okay? Now, value, which can mean also the brightness, is a degree of light and dark in color. How much light and how much dark? It is the contrast between black and white, contrast and everything in between. So white and black and everything what comes in between. Now, value can be used on its own with the gray. Or it can be added to color. So we have a primary color and then we add gray to it, okay? The contrast means the extremes, okay? Like for example, the extreme contrast we see between white and black, that's huge contrast, okay? And the contrast is needed to help us and understand a design. Now, for example, if there was no contrast between this writing, do you see my font? It's black, the font color that I used, it's black. So what is the background color of the page? It's white. This creates big contrast between the font and the background. Now, if the contrast was not huge, okay? So, for example, I put a gray color like this. I write the text using this color, okay? This gray. Then when you see it and you try to read, it will not be very clear. Because between this color, let's say this here and the white, there is not much contrast. There is not much contrast. So the less contrast you have, the less clear you see the information. Now, sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's okay. And sometimes you have certain areas of your design that have high contrast, other areas less contrast for certain reasons. But you must know where you put it and to what degree to make your design to communicate correctly. So we already said that value is the lightness or darkness of an object. So for example, look at this. How light is this object or how dark? Okay. Differences in value can make an object more visible or less. We already talked about this. Look at this, for example, image, illustration. This is much more visible than this because of the differences in value, the contrast. Value can indicate also importance or emphasis. It can create emphasis again, like we want to see a certain area or a certain area to stand out from the design. We can use value to do that. Also, your eyes usually see and go directly to the darker object. Like when you look at this, for example, your eye first goes to this one because it's darker. Now, because this dark object is on a light background. Look at the background, it's white. This is black. So the contrast is huge. That's why our eye first goes here. Now, if the background is dark gray, like this, for example, color, okay? So if here we have dark gray, this will not stand out. It will not stand out. But the lighter one will stand out. So it depends on what's on the background, okay? Value can make us, you can play with value to show distance. Like for example, objects that are close, if you make them darker, it creates a feeling that they are closer. If they're lighter, it creates a feeling that they are away from us, in the distance. Like this, for example, okay? This looks as if it's closer to us than this. Now, if I also change the size, so I also change the size, make this bigger and this smaller, it will even be more stronger. So we will talk about size, you know, later on. But as I said, in any design, you are not using just one element or two elements of design. And we also have principles of design that we also will discuss later. So the way you combine the elements with the principles together, how many elements, which elements, which principles of design, all this can create different results, different designs, and a different communication. So we already discussed that value can be just using black and white and the grays in between, or it can be used with color. So we start with a primary color and we add gray to it, for example, to make the color closer to the gray, I would say. It depends on really on the design. Look at these examples, for example. Now here, color with gray has been used, okay? Tone. So here also we have gray, but we have also color combinations. So a primary color combined with grays for certain effects. Or like this is pure gray. White, black, and the grays in between. So this is in general for now for you to know. That's enough. This was our last element of design, basically. And next class, we will talk about the principles of design. So we will start the principles of design next time. See you soon.